and welcome to episode 62 of Bitches of Horror.
And in this episode, we're going to talk about extreme horror film.
Yeah.
Yes, we've had a few underground, you know, gore ones, but this one is closely similar.
just lots of
gore
nasty
and nastiness.
Gore. Yeah. Goodness.
And we're going to start with a sort of, like, now-time classic, a Serbian film.
Yeah, Serbski film.
Yeah, 2010. You want to try to pronounce his name?
Well, since I'm Polish, Serdian Spasojevic. That's how I would pronounce it as a Polish woman.
Yeah, it's from Serbia, as you might have known. It's about a man, an ex-porn star, who gets a job from a man to do some stuff for lots of money. And he takes the job because he... You know, they're out of cash. His family needs money for his family.
He doesn't know what he's gonna do, actually. So that's where the danger is.
He's just like,
being
my film of randomness, you know, sort of.
Yeah, they're going to make an artistic porno.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it's an old porn star of his, old porn star friend of his who, you know, hooks him up with this guy.
Wow, when I saw this film the first time, it blew my mind.
I wasn't that impressed.
I was. I mean, the cinematography
is
excellent. It's so good.
It's pretty.
It's amazing.
I think that my thing was that people had hyped up this movie so much. They were like, not that it was good, but more the like, oh, it's so nasty.
I think that's
so
the
bad.
People who aren't so
I know,
used
but still
watching
people had still hyped up this thing. And they were like, it's so disgusting. Yeah. And then I watched it, and the one scene that everyone talks about, you know, I watched the scene, and I was like, it looks fake.
But I watched the scene, too, and I was like, yeah, that looks totally fake, but I love this movie anyway. Mm. So, yeah.
I think
but
I was just expecting
the same
more
thing
nastiness.
Raw. When people were like, oh, people
yeah,
this
but
is
raw.
Disgusting.
I knew that wasn't going to be that disgusting, but this one was like, you know, it was supposed to be disgusting. Or, he says it's supposed to be for other reasons, but it was supposed to be disgusting. And
But the story was kind of disgusting.
Yeah,
the turn points and what happens at the end.
Yeah, that of course.
That was very creative.
That's a different type of disgusting, though.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
That's more
mentally.
Gets you mentally.
Yeah.
And you're like, whoa.
I wanted to get it visually, like, and one of the scenes that I remembered in my head was not the same scene that was in the film this time because I watched it now. It was the scene with the bed. I would say, I don't know,
oh,
with
yeah.
the machete.
You just remember it differently, or
yeah, I don't really know if I want to spoil it, like, but everyone's seen it, but basically, I thought he cut somewhere else,
and
he did cut a whole different place, and I was like, oh man, and it was like one of my favorite scenes ever made, and then I watched it, I was like,
and
no,
it was
it ruins
all in
it.
Your head,
it was all in my head, I was like, okay, maybe I should do that.
Yeah, maybe you should do that. So, yeah.
But you know, one thing I do have to give this film is that it has a great SFX, like
it's amazing.
Yeah.
It's so good.
Out of the world. The only thing that fucking gets me the whole time is his dick. His dick is so bad.
Yeah, we talked about bad dick.
Bad dick syndrome. Like, it looks so fake. It looks so much like a strap-on. Like, it's ridiculous. Like, it's just too big. Like, I know there's some porn stars out there that have, you know, huge cock and, you know, what's his face? Boogie Nights man.
Yeah. But when I saw, like, shots of his dick, I was like,
fake.
Oh, that would... Mm.
Yeah, like it was just, it was too much, and it just looked too rubbery, you know. It doesn't look like that. And that
but
was
he
the
uses
only thing.
It very creatively in one scene.
Yeah, I mean,
that was.
Yeah. It's a good scene.
Like, the ending, like the last 20 minutes are just so crazy and amazing. And
yeah.
Wow.
I actually think that Milos is sexy. There's something about
something
him
about
that
it.
Just makes me like, ooh.
You just want him to
just...
like grab you and be like,
yeah.
Okay.
Even though he looks like David Spade, you know.
Serbian.
Yeah,
David
but he's
Spade.
Still like, he's like dirty. You're like, oh, yeah. Mm.
But I do like him and I liked his family, his wife. Mm. I do like her. And the brother. Disgusting.
He is so nasty.
Nasty.
He's like super like 70s nasty porn king.
Yeah.
Yeah. One thing that I found out that I didn't know since I'm not from Serbia is that Milos, I can't remember his name right now, but he is one of the biggest actors in
Serbia.
I
had no idea.
Him and
like,
I think
wow.
the guy who hired him, those two are like one, like the biggest, I think it was him, someone else, him and someone else, are the biggest actors in Serbia.
Right.
For them to actually do a film like this is amazing.
I wish we had like our top Swedish
yeah,
actors
it's like
Alexander
Skarsgård and, you know, okay, it's him and Stellan, father and son, but like, or Noomi Rapace, like,
oh,
the,
yeah.
They wouldn't, I don't think they would do a film like this. I really don't.
Let's do a Swedish film.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, same in America. You would never see, like, Angelina Jolie and, I don't know, Brad Pitt. I don't know who else is. Who's famous? Tom Cruise? I don't know. In this type of film.
Yeah, it's
maybe
a shame.
Johnny Depp, but I doubt it.
Maybe if he got into weird costume and
yeah.
makeup and I don't know.
Yeah, but you'd never see like huge
yeah.
actors like that do that,
it's
which is amazing. Yeah, and also I do, you know, I think that this film is slow. Like, I don't know what it is, but it's slow.
For me, even though it might be slow sometimes, I think just the ending and when stuff do happen, it like makes up for it. In my
yeah,
opinion.
But
it
just it
does.
Feels like it's like slow and then it's like boom, shit happens. Slow, boom, shit happens.
Because you need to have a break.
But it's not, but it's
like,
not even like a build-up. It's more just like, oh, okay, well now we're going to have a cup of tea. Oh shit, his dick went into his ears and broke his fucking nose or something. And that doesn't happen in the film. But, you know, I'm just, you know, that's how extreme.
That is Jasmine's wet fantasy.
This is my future film. Dick's like, oh, ears and breaks your nose. Well, you know, things like that, it just, you know, it's not really out of place, but there's no actual build-up to it. And I think that's my biggest issue with the film. While all the booming incidents, they build up until the big finale, which that is really good. But I just think, like, the in-between parts needed some tweaking.
Some pacing.
Yeah.
I also do like the music.
Yes, fantastic music. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Absolutely amazing music. Music, cinematography.
Story.
The story overall.
Yeah.
It's the pacing. And the fact that he said, Serdjan, I can't say his name, the director, that he made this film to show that the Serbian government is manipulating or brainwashing the Serbian people.
Yeah, but it was like they brainwashed Miloš.
Yeah, but I think it's a stupid way to show it. And I think it's an excuse, to be honest, to make a...
Just ignore the fact that it's
yeah,
like that.
Like, I know, but it's like, just say that you wanted to gross people out. You know, I'd respect that. I mean, I can understand his like view of it a little bit. But I think, you know, if that's the point you want to get across, there's a lot, you know, a lot more effectful... There comes again, effective ways of doing it.
Effectful.
I'm pretty
because
sure it's not
we
word.
Say that in Swedish. It's effectful.
Nej, effektivt.
Well, we say, what? Don't we say effectful? Yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
Your words are mind-fucking
yeah.
me.
But, yeah.
yeah. So, after all, what do you give this?
I'm going to give it a 7 out of 10. It's still a solid film.
It's more than solid. It's a 10 out of 10.
Really?
Yeah. I love this film, as you can tell by my amazing shirt.
I would wear a shirt, but, you know,
yeah.
It's not my favorite. Oh, wait, I'm not done yet. Here we go. Next up, we got Gutterballs.
Yeah, by Ryan Nicholson from 2008.
It's from Canada.
Yeah.
And I've been wanting to see this film for a long time. It was mentioned in Gorgasmic. I think the second one.
Yeah, they do mention a lot of Nicholson's work.
Yeah.
Because he's a great SFX artist. So his movies contain a lot of nasty
yeah.
SFX. And this one is no different.
No.
And it's about a girl who, she is at a bowling alley with her friends. And they bowl against another team. And the other team are a bunch of
rival,
men.
Yeah.
Who, they clash. They,
yeah, right.
They get angry and blah blah blah, and then the girl forgets her purse, I think, at the bowling alley. So she gets back to get it and gets brutally gang raped
yes.
by the rivals. So yeah, that's basically about what I can tell without spoiling it.
Yes, This rape scene in particular is
so hard.
One of the
watch.
Worst I watched. Like, not bad, but like, just it's very
hard
to watch.
Endure,
like, yeah.
You just want it to end. You're like, I mean, of course, it's not. I don't take pleasure in watching fake rape scenes in movies, but this one was just.
Yeah, like usually I don't really. I'm not that up to it, you know. When it, rape scenes, I'm not usually like, oh, I'm dying, it's so bad. I mean, of course, rape is horrible, but it doesn't really. Doesn't have that effect on me. But this scene in particular, there are some rape scenes out there. This is one of them. This one and the one in The Hills Have Eyes 2 remake.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. They. This one, like, really had an effect, and this was probably one of the worst I've seen. Mm-hmm. Like, it was really hard.
It was really brutal.
Yeah.
And just raw and. No.
Yeah, but it gave really, I mean, put a
big spot in the film. Yeah, it did what it was supposed to do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not saying don't do it, because, you know, I like films that make me feel, and this film definitely made me feel.
I want to feel, like, awful.
Yeah.
I want to see something and be like, oh.
Yes. I mean, just like a Serbian film, like, that film also made you feel awful. That scene made you just like, oh, this scene and this, which the rape scene is,
So, of course, after that scene, all you want to do is see these guys die.
Yeah.
Basically. So.
There's great, fantastic SFX in this film.
Very creative.
Yeah.
Like, very creative use of bowling pins in this one. Great SFX, great gore, and. But some characters were
too much.
Just no depth. Like, I mean,
usually
these kinds of films doesn't have much character depth, but some characters,
they're just empty.
Shells. They felt so unnecessary. Like, just get rid of.
Even like the main bad guy. Like, you understood he was bad. That's fine. But it was just too much. Like, he was over the top bad guy.
Yeah.
And like, just not like in like an evil way. More like a douchey fucking tool. Ugh. Yeah, I really hope there's no people like him in real life, because shoot me. But like, it was just like, that was like too much. And a douche is a douche is what I wrote.
But I do like the ending very much.
Yes, the ending is good. There was a blowjob scene that I was actually contemplating if it was real or not.
Oh.
I'm like, is that real? I'm not sure. It looked really real.
Yeah.
Which is good. Oh, y'all good. Everyone loves a BJ. There was a mask as well.
Oh, yeah.
That I really liked.
Some death scenes were just so over the
top.
Yeah,
and like creative.
Funny. You're like, wow, they actually died that way. Okay.
Yeah. I think the only thing, like, except for some of the characters were being bleh, is that this film got a little bit slow in between the beginning and like half the way to the end. Like, the middle part was very slow.
Yeah, there
slow.
Were some scenes you could have cut down or cut out to make the pace better, but.
But overall, this was a fun. I mean, even though terrible things happen, it's a fun film. Fun and hard. Like, it was weird. Like, sometimes you'd laugh and have fun, and sometimes you're like, oh my god, please stop.
Yeah.
So. This one made you feel a bunch of different emotions.
Yeah.
And overall, I give this an 8 out of 10.
8 out of 10.
I loved it. It was really good.
I do like Nicholson's work. I've seen a few.
I think this is the only one I've seen, actually. But I need
to
check out more of this work.
We need to do a Nicholson
episode. Yeah.
Okay, moving on to another brutal film.
Yes.
Atrocious from 2015 by Lex Ortega.
From Mexico.
Yeah.
And this I actually watched with 13th Floor, David and Jeremiah, when I was there in Florida in February. And everybody was just taken aback by this film, because it was just, whoa.
Yeah, it's something else.
Yeah. It's about a man, prostitute, and his story, I guess.
Yeah.
Easiest way to...
Say something without spoiling it, but
it's
like two cops, they arrest a guy and they find videotapes.
Yeah.
And these videotapes show some pretty brutal, nasty stories. And this film is very brutal in a raw way.
It's very dirty.
Yeah, it's not like it's the gore is glamorized, or you know, like
it's not a Serbian film.
Yeah, it's not like a modern day gore film with its good lighting, and it you feel good. If
everything
you
is dark,
see,
gray,
yeah,
and gritty. It's very gritty.
Raw, yeah, it's nasty, and the gore is very creative.
Oh my God, yeah.
It really hits you. I mean, I saw this film 3 or 4 days ago, and I can't stop thinking about some of the scenes. It's stuck in my head, and it's not pleasurable scenes. Yeah, I wrote down that this film made me feel awful, and it's good.
Yeah.
I love feeling
it's a good
awful
thing. It is very disturbing.
Yeah,
it is, and I feel that this film is very original. Like I've heard people talk shit about this film, and I cannot see why. Like, it's so original, and it's just takes disturbing to a whole different level. It's so nasty, gritty, and you're like, it's like, ugh, like half the time.
You see something horrible, and you're like, oh, okay, I saw that. Nothing can beat that. And then comes the next scene, and it tops that, and you're like, what will I see next? What? I mean, this is crazy.
It is.
It's in a good way.
Yeah, I was very surprised by this film. And there's one specific scene that is just like,
shot.
It's just so creative. And
that shot
just right here, so creative. And it just,
like,
blew me away. Like, when it happened, when we were watching it, everyone was like, whoa.
Yeah, when I saw
what?
It, I couldn't believe that I actually got to see that.
Yeah.
I was like, what? No, they did
it. Yeah.
Oh.
It's really cool how they did it. And everyone who's watched this film knows exactly what scene it is.
Yeah.
But everything, like, the story's disgusting.
The people
facts,
are disgusting.
The people, everyone's a
the
terrible
characters,
person.
Because like, you're rooting for someone, and then you're like, no, but he's terrible. Everyone is terrible. Like, oh my God. But it's like, it's real life. People are terrible.
Yeah. Like, people are shit, you know?
Yeah.
The only thing that I have to say about this film is that sometimes it could be a little bit all over the place, so you kind of like lose grip of like what's going on.
Yeah.
But it kind of ties together everything
in
towards
the
end, so you feel a little bit more, you know, okay, well, we're here now, sort of. But you know, I really enjoy this film, and every gore fan, every you know underground horror fan needs to watch this.
This is the film to watch.
Yeah. I think this has a lot of basic gore. I mean, not like, but it brings gore back to basics. Like, there's no like bullshit, and there's a story. You know, this kind of brought me back to Headless. Like, it's gore with story, and I love a bit of story. Like, it doesn't have to be a love story or whatever. Just that there's some sort of background to the characters, and it makes everything so much better, in my opinion. Like in Headless, where you could see the background of the killer, and the same thing in Atroz, but they do it in a different way, and it gives you depth, and even if you don't like the characters, you still have an understanding of them.
Yeah,
and I really think that Lex Ortega put this together really good.
Yeah, me too.
And I love this film. Like, it is one of my favorite.
It's very good.
Probably one of my favorite core films, films.
What do you give this?
9 out of 10.
Me too. 9 out of 10.
It's really good.
Yeah. So let's move on to our short film of the week.
Yes. We had a chance to see this when Harry Collins put up for 24 hours, I think, or just overnight. Last Days of Livermore.
Yeah. From 2017 by Harry Collins from the United States.
And we know Harry Collins from our gore group, forum, and he's a great guy and
always supporting gore and independent filmmaking and
overall
nice, great guy. So I was very excited when I was given the opportunity to watch,
especially because he's been like posting stuff about it, like, oh yeah, look at the scenes we shot today and stuff like that.
And he seems so very passionate about filmmaking and gore and horror.
Yeah,
so I knew that I would see something that would come from his heart.
And first of all, this is a very low-budget film. I was surprised, actually, how much of a good story it had.
Yeah, me too. That was the most surprising part, because I was so sure about one thing, and then towards the end, it just completely turned, and I was like, wow.
Yeah.
This was really good.
That
good
was,
story.
Like... And even though, like, Harry is a good guy and everything, but, you know, gore hounds are gore hounds, and they... a lot of underground gore is absolute shit. Don't get me wrong, I love gore, I love underground films, I love extreme films, but a lot of it is terrible. But and a lot of it doesn't have any background, or just it's just, you know, bleh.
Mm-hmm.
But this one is it has background.
Yeah.
And it was thought through. It wasn't just, oh, let's make gore. It was thought through.
And that's the best part.
It was.
That it feels thought through also. And that just
puts more love into it.
Yeah, enhances the gore also when it happens. Enhances everything.
The acting was okay. It wasn't fantastic. It wasn't bad.
Yeah.
I thought it was acceptable acting.
And I think the location was very good. It was a smart choice to keep it simple, keep it within one or two locations, and just focus on the cemetery.
Yes.
Because it's about a man and a woman that are driving to a cemetery, and they seem to be fighting a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just not on each other at this time.
Yeah.
Some scenes I thought had too much blood for what had happened.
I think that was maybe editing issues. It felt like that because maybe they had filmed one sequence with a lot of blood and they had one with less, and when they were trying to put it together they noticed that.
I don't know, I just felt like, you know, if you have this kind of wound, I mean, I love, you know, blood, don't get me wrong, but like it was like waterfall.
But I also think, you know, gorehounds.
It will be gorehounds, yeah.
More is better.
But I like the SFX. And,
yeah, me too.
Yeah, just the chemistry between the two were very good.
Yeah, because you really felt for them.
Yeah.
Like, I was feeling so sorry for the girl, and I was just, oh, I didn't really know what was going to happen.
No.
No.
But I really did like how it ended, and I
liked,
like, everything about it, and I think it's a solid film, short film, especially coming from the gore underground world.
Yeah, I wrote simple but effective.
Yes.
Yeah. And I can't wait to see more from Harry.
Yes.
Definitely.
And me too.
Yeah, loving the gore and the story.
Yes.
I will give this an 8 out of 10.
Me too. 8 out of 10.
Oh.
Fantastic. I mean, I love when indie horror filmmakers actually, like, put their heart into things.
Yeah, you could definitely
and make it
feel
work. Yeah.
The heart. Yeah.
So I hope to see more from him, and I hope to see more gore with
more
background.
Nasty gore.
Yes.
Yeah.
With great effects. We all love a great effect, and all, you know.
We always want to,
we just want to
see someone push the boundaries. Like,
yeah.
How much further can we go?
If you just think like Guinea Pig, like the first two, like how they came out of nowhere, and in that time, you know, just looked so real. It's just so brutal.
Even going back to Herschel
Gordon Lewis,
like when he made The Wizard of Gore, like he really pushed the envelope for what we can do.
I mean, that was a different age and it's harder to push.
Yeah, yeah, but imagine being 1960 and seeing that for the first time.
Yeah.
Like, whoa. And going to today.
Yes.
We still can shock people. Even though we've seen a lot, there's always a way to push the boundaries to shock people. And we're always looking for that.
Yes.
Yeah.
And thanks for this episode.
Yeah.
And we'll do some more episodes after this.
Hopefully.
Yeah. And new themes to come, some country specific themes and so on. So I look forward to that.
Thanks for watching and keep liking and sharing our stuff.
Stay horrific.
Bye.
Bye.